the Seattle Pacific University student, who witnesses say tackled a campus gunman during a deadly shooting Thursday, reportedly has had his wedding registry and honeymoon paid for by strangers, after accounts of his heroics spread on the internet. The Center for Competitive Politics has filed a complaint with the Senate Select Committee on Ethics, claiming New York Senator Chuck Schumer and other Senate Democrats used the IRS to deny the free speech of political opponents. The complaint also mentions a Schumer speech titled, The Rise of the Tea Party and How Progressives Can Fight Back. The Center for Competitive Politics says the speech demonstrated how the IRS could be used to attack Tea Party groups. A member of Army Sergeant Bo Bergdahl's platoon in Afghanistan says the former Taliban prisoner deserted his post before being captured and fired back against Obama administration arguments that only Bergdahl knows exactly what happened. Speaking on Lou Dobbs Tonight, Dr. Loudon says that President Obama is displaying erratic and irrational behavior that may be indicative of someone who may not be sane. A couple has been arrested by police on suspicion of cruelty and neglect of their obese child. A 49-year-old man and a 44-year-old woman from King's Lynn in Norfolk, England, were questioned by officers of the child's care and released on bail. Susan Rice admits U.S. giving arms to Al-Qaeda in Syria. On Friday, Obama's top foreign policy advisor, Susan Rice, said this minuscule contingent of moderate mercenaries are now receiving weapons from the United States. The O.J. Simpson case is now 20 years old, and evidence collected by a private investigator points to his son. Detective Deer concludes that O.J. didn't kill his wife and her friend, but he did visit the scene of the crime shortly after it occurred, and that evidence suggests his son Jason, who was 24 at the time, did it in a rage killing. Sergeant Bo Bergdahl has declined to speak to his family after 5 years in captivity, according to a U.S. official familiar with the Army soldier's recovery. And now for sports news. Rafael Nadal of Spain won an unprecedented 9th French Open Championship Sunday, denying Serbia's Novak Djokovic his quest to secure a career Grand Slam, with the only major he lacks. The Los Angeles Kings won for the fourth time in these playoffs after trailing by 2 goals, including Game 1 of this series, when Dustin Brown redirected a blast by Willie Mitchell with 10:26 to go into the second overtime period, as the Los Angeles Kings hold a 2-0 lead over the New York Rangers in the Stanley Cup Final. Tonight the San Antonio Spurs will play the Miami Heat in Game 2 of the NBA Finals. San Antonio leads the series 1-0. Congratulations goes out to Dale Earnhardt Jr. for winning the Pocono 400 in NASCAR. And now for entertainment news. Los Angeles police are investigating an incident at the home of actress Sandra Bullock, in which an unidentified male suspect gained entry into her residence. The Kinks may reunite for new album and tour. It's been over 20 years since their last album, but the Kinks could be reforming for a new album and tour, according to lead singer Ray Davies. The Tony Awards are tonight, and will be hosted by Hugh Jackman.